Welcome back, folks. Today I'm adding an external audio jack to a Google Home Mini, so keep watching and I'll show you how it's done. A quick shout out to Charlie Haywood for providing this speaker to us to do the mod on, and we're going to add the headphone jack right about here. It's pretty much the only spot I could find room. If you like what I do, please hit that subscribe button and like the video, and let's jump into it. Now, the guy that I watched to do this, he used hot water, and I didn't really like hot water as a method for removing this, so I've gone with my trusty old heat gun that I use during phone repairs, and as you can see in my nice little sped up video here, just using the heat gun, taking your time, probably on about 150 to 200 degrees I've got this set to, and as you can see, it's a very slow and tedious process, but I finally managed to get a tool in underneath, and she lifts off pretty easily once it's warm enough, but that adhesive is stuck on really tight, so just take your time and take care, otherwise this piece of rubber will rip. But yeah, that's him, popped off, snappity day, and all done. On to the next step is removing the screws. So I'll quickly fast forward through this bit, because can't imagine that being too exciting to watch. Okay, so we're back and we're opening the device up now. There's a cable inside to watch out for, so don't open it too quickly. That one's a crocodile clip. You'll see where I just pulled the tab up and slide the cable out. Make sure you do this properly. If you break that crocodile clip connector, it can be a real doozy to try and put back together. Contact me if you do that, and I'll show you a few methods on how to sort that one out. So you can see here is where I remove the cable and open up the connector properly. The screws to remove to get into the unit, so that's what we're doing here. And then we can pull that one out. There is another little cable hiding underneath, so if we look carefully, you can see that one here. Again, don't rush into opening these things, so just pull him lightly, he should pop off. That's going to give us access to these wires, and then we can look at soldering the project together. So we'll move on to the next section. I'm going to start by stripping a tiny section on each wire so it gives me a point to solder to, and we're going to attach each of the resistors to this bit here. So I might do a little bit of a fast forwardy and see you at the end of this. Ah, the magic of video editing. Right, so now that that's done, we're going to get our resistors ready. The recommended was 3K and 300 ohm. I had 3K and 270 ohm. Close enough's good enough. So I think that worked out to a 10% ratio. Whatever that was all going on about. Someone can explain that in the comments if they like. All I know is it works and it saves the amplifier inside the Google Home Mini from blowing up. So these are fairly critical, impedance I think is the word, but yeah, we're just going to twist the legs together on these for one end and leave the other end as is, and then they're prepared for... And we're back to the project. We've got the resistors getting soldered onto the wires here. You can see we've got the 3K on the positive wire and the 300 ohm on the negative wire, if I've remembered that correctly. I will go back and double check and label this in the actual video so it's a bit easier to see. So you're probably looking at labels right now. It's really hard actually trying to pre-plan what you're doing in the editing phase, but we'll get there. Now, we can see here that the negative wire gets attached to the negative wire. We can get the resistor. That's going on to, I think this is like the left port for the audio jack. You could connect it to the right port as well. And we've also got the ground connection as well for that. So connect ground to ground. Here's a labeled section of it anyway, if you couldn't make sense of my jargony talk. Moving on, I could not fit this in for the life of me, so just get all Destructo on it. This did work. The speaker was already damaged before starting the project, that's why we were doing this, so I'm not really worried about the hole that I've created. Some others might be, so I'd look for a smaller audio jack before starting the project if that's the case. But aside from that, you can see this cable is a real bugger to get back in. That was not the first take of doing this. I think there was like 10 takes. So, again, the magic of editing. And now while talking away, I've managed to get the screws put back in. And now we've just got to line the back rubber plate thing back on. Now there's a little dot on the back that lines up with the button. That's for like factory reset and things like that. Just make sure you got that line back up properly, otherwise you go through the fun like I did of having to remove this again. So hopefully by me mentioning that, I can save somebody else the trouble that I went through. As you can see, I'm trying to point that out quite clearly, so please take caution, heed my warning. Aside from that, if you guys have enjoyed this video, please hit that subscribe button, hit the like button, that helps it get noticed by YouTube a bit more. I would greatly appreciate that. But yeah, so from that, you can see, proud of my job here. It looks pretty good at the end. Come up, going together quite nicely. And I'll do a little test for you guys, just so that you can see how it works. There's a minor delay, but I think it serves its intended purpose. Count to 10.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
How's that for a hack, eh? If that doesn't earn you subscribe, I don't know what will.